Welcome. And in this session, we are going to look at the terms accuracy and precision with respect to measurement systems. In electrical engineering, generally we come across these two terms, accuracy and precision. Generally, the notion is that these two terms mean the same thing, but it is not true. We can see accuracy and precision in two ways. One of them is a qualitative way, and another one is a quantitative way. In a qualitative way, we compare two different instruments and compare between their accuracy and precision. And in quantitative way, we want to measure how accurate is the instrument is and how precise is the instrument. Our objective is to look at the accuracy and precision in qualitative way. For this example, I have taken three dart boards. Often you may have come across dart boards where player uses arrows to hit at a dart, and your objective is to hit in the middle of the dart board. Now, if we assume that the player who is hitting the arrows is an instrument, the instrument wants to measure the correct value, the actual value. Let us say this middle dot or the middle point is the actual value that the player wants to hit. Now, these marks all show where the player has actually hit the arrows. Now, if there are three players, let us say player A, player B and player C. Now, in the first case, player A hits at the dart boards and we can look at these marks. Now, these marks are scattered. If we say, if player would have hit in the middle, player would have been accurate. So, in this case, the player is certainly not accurate. But what exactly is precision? Precision can be seen from this example. Player B has hit at the dart board at the exact same place multiple times. If we calculate the mean of these values, it will be around here. Now the deviation from the mean of all the readings is very less. But still, the player is not accurate, but we can say the player is precise. This player was not even precise, not even accurate. Now, we just have to make a small correction in the instrument to make it accurate. Now, because the instrument is precise, it is a little bit easier for us to make it accurate. Now, in this example, this is the ideal case. We would always choose this player to play in our team. This player C has hit all the darts in the middle, which is an ideal case, which does not happen every time, as you know of. The player has hit all the readings in the middle, who is accurate as well as precise. This is how we compare different accuracies and precisions. If we want to measure the accuracy and precision in quantitative way, what we do is we use deviation from mean, standard deviation technique. We have to calculate mean and other statistical methods. All the branches of statistical methods always relate to the measurement systems. So this is about accuracy and precision. Thank you.